Hi, more and more suppliers are developing devices that support Matter. Zemismart sent me some devices that should support Matter. Let's find out how they work in Home Assistant. Zemismart sent me some devices to test if they work with Matter. They all support Google Home, Alexa, SmartThings and HomeKit. Being a Home Assistant enthusiast, I want to see if they work with Home Assistant using the Sky Connect and how I can control them. Zemismart sent me the following devices: a smart color light bulb, a smart downlight, a smart roller motor, and a smart curtain kit. Let's start with the smart color light bulb. There's a sticker with the QR code on the side of the light bulb. I'd suggest taking a picture of the sticker, writing down the code, and storing it somewhere safe so that you can always connect this light bulb even if you lose the sticker. There's also a copy of the QR code in the manual of your light bulb, so you can store that in a safe place too. We must put the light bulb in pairing mode by switching it on and off 5 times. You need to use the Home Assistant Companion app to pair a Matter device to Home Assistant. Go to Settings, Devices and Services, and click Add Integration. Now choose Add Matter Device and scan the QR code on the light bulb. Home Assistant will try to connect to the light bulb now. I tried to connect it multiple times, but the light bulb just wouldn't connect, so I investigated what the cause could be and tried to connect the light bulb using HomeKit. That didn't work either, and it made me think that something else must have been wrong in my network. Then I remembered that I use AdGuard to block advertisements in my network and that this might have an impact on connecting to this light bulb. So I disabled AdGuard and pairing to the light bulb using HomeKit worked after that. I'm not really sure if AdGuard was the issue or that there were some communication issues, because I asked the guys from Home Assistant and they told me that there might still be communication issues using the Sky Connect and Matter. Anyway, this is the way how I made it work. Then I paired the light bulb to Home Assistant using the Sky Connect, and that worked too. So now I can control the light bulb using Home Assistant. The light bulb itself has very bright colors, and I also like the warm white and cold white colors. I'm definitely going to use this light bulb in my own house. This light bulb also works with Google Home, Alexa, SmartThings and HomeKit. The price of this light bulb is currently $13.67 for one piece and gets cheaper when you order multiple light bulbs. You can buy it on AliExpress, Amazon and the official Zemismart store. You will find a link to where you can buy this light bulb in the description of this video. I also left some coupon codes in the description so that you can buy them at a discount. Then I tried to connect the smart downlight. The downlight comes with a transformer and can be connected to the main power directly. First, I had to put it into pairing mode by turning it on and off 10 times. After that, I tried to add it to Home Assistant just like I did with the light bulb. This time the pairing worked immediately and I could control the colors and brightness of the smart downlight. Very cool! The downlight is super bright. You do not see the LED inside and the colors are vibrant. This downlight also works with Google Home, Alexa, SmartThings and HomeKit. The only thing with these lights is that the lowest brightness looks still very bright to me, but to be honest, I experienced the same with other smart lights. The price of this downlight is currently $31.29 for the smallest version. You can buy it on AliExpress, Amazon and in the official Zemismart store. The link to where you can buy these with a discount is in the description of this video. Check it out! Now let's set up the third device, which is the roller motor for our roller blinds. This motor can be put into your existing roller blind so that you can make your existing roller blinds smart. There's a remote control in the package that can be used to set up the up limit, down limit and middle limit settings. You'll need to set up the top, middle and bottom positions to control the roller motor using a percentage in Home Assistant. To pair it, I needed to push the reset pin 3 times. Then I can start adding a new integration in Home Assistant and Home Assistant will start searching for the roller motor. This roller motor connects straight away to Home Assistant using the Sky Connect dongle. It shows as a cover in Home Assistant and you can open and close it fully, but you can also open it by a percentage. Installing the roller motor was really easy and the connection is very stable. And of course, this roller motor works with Google Home, Alexa, SmartThings and HomeKit too. The price of this roller motor, including the remote, is currently $66.47. You can buy different variations at AliExpress, Amazon and in the official Zemismart store at a discount if you use the links and coupon codes in the description of this video. Now let's head over to the biggest device that Zemismart sent to me, the Zemismart Smart Curtain Track. This thing is massive. It's so well built and robust that I feel that it can handle very heavy curtains. The curtain track can be adjusted in length so that it fits your curtain. There are various sets available up to a track length of 5 meters. You can charge the motor battery so that it works for a week when the power is cut off. The motor is really strong and can run at 3 speeds so that you can choose how fast you want the curtains to open and close. This curtain track comes with a remote control so that you can control the track without having to use your phone. And when you pull the curtain manually, the motor also starts automatically. The curtain track uses Matter over Thread and it works with HomeKit, Google Home, SmartThings and Alexa. Connecting it to HomeKit was fairly easy. To connect it to HomeKit, you need a Matter hub like the HomePod Mini or an Apple TV 4K 2nd generation or higher. I use the HomePod Mini as a Matter hub. First, you need to put the curtain track in pairing mode by clicking the reset button 3 times. Then you can add the curtain track in HomeKit by opening the Home app and clicking on the plus sign and selecting Add Accessory. Then scan the QR code and the curtain track will be added to HomeKit. After that, you can control it with HomeKit. After I connected this curtain track to HomeKit, I tried to connect it to Home Assistant, and after a couple of failed attempts, I managed to connect it to Home Assistant as well, so that I can now control the curtain track in Home Assistant. I can open and close the curtain, but can also select a percentage to not fully close or open the curtains. This is great. Now I can close my curtains automatically when everybody leaves the house when it's dark, for example. The price of this curtain track varies based on the length that you choose. The 2-meter set costs $179.64 and the longer set of 5 meters costs $222.75. You can buy the curtain track at AliExpress and at the official ZemiSmart store. If you follow the links in the description of the video and use the coupon codes that are added there, you can buy them at a discount. I must say, getting these devices to work was quite an adventure. Matter is still in beta on Home Assistant, so sometimes I struggle to get them to work. But in the end, I managed to pair every device in Home Assistant using the SkyConnect. If you want to know more about the SkyConnect, then please watch this video where I explain what it is and what you can do with it. I must say that the response time is super fast, and when the devices are set up, the connection is very stable. So yeah, I'm happy with these devices, and I think ZemiSmart did a great job to release these devices that support Matter. If you find my videos helpful, please consider becoming my sponsor just like these people did. I need your help to keep this channel alive and provide you with the latest smart home and home assistant news and tutorials. You'll find links to Patreon, Ko-fi, and how you can join my channel in the description of the video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to make the channel grow. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye. To pair it, I needed to push the push. It's so well built and robust.